Hey guys, welcome back to TechProvids. In this video, we're going to see what is advanced filter and how it works. As you all know, how normal filter works by clicking the drop-down buttons, right? Here, we are going to provide some inputs to the advanced filter to filter the data accordingly. So, what is the advanced filter? The advanced filter will help us to filter the data by providing the conditions. The conditions can be a text or wildcard characters or logical operators. Using this condition, we can easily filter large data in just click of a button. Using the wildcard characters like asterisk will return the data using the partial match, and by using the logical operators like greater than or equal to, or lesser than or equal to. So these logical operators we can apply on column like numbers. Let's get into the video. Okay guys, now we can see how the advanced filter works. Here the data will be we are going to use as a data source for the advanced filter. I have a serial number column, employee ID, employee name and salary. Okay, so let's get into advanced filter. Okay, before that, if anyone wants to know about the how the basic filter works, then we can go through that. So just select the range, the data, and click on the data tab and click the filter. So that will put the drop down on all the columns. You can select whichever you want by checking the checkbox here and press OK. That will filter out the data, right? Likewise, you can also do the logical operators like equals, does not equal, greater than less than, or whatever it is. Yeah, or like greater than. So I want the employee ID starting greater than 505, then we will be getting 506 and 50, so this data. So this is how the filter is works. Okay, now our question is, what is advanced filter will do? Okay, so instead of doing the manual thing, we are going to do condition based filter here. Okay, so what is a condition based filter? Let's go to that. Okay, so here I have serial number, employee ID and employee name, salary, right? So copy this header, employee ID, employee name and salary, paste it above here. Okay, here we're going to use the conditions. So we are going to type conditions here. It will be like numbers, wildcard characters and logical operators which we seen before. Okay, now let's apply the advanced filter. Okay, select the complete data source whichever you want and click advanced here. It says the first option, it's by default selected, filter the list in place. Okay, the list range will automatically select because you have selected the range before you clicked. So it will automatically click the list range, that is A5 to D17. Then the next tab is criteria range. So this is what we are referring to, the conditions. Click on this button and select this header along with the row, the below row. Okay, now click OK. Okay, so now we have put the list range and the criteria range, we have applied that. Okay, now we're going to use the filter. Like I want to filter Adams. Okay, copy this, paste it here. Okay, make sure you select inside any of the range, like A5 to D17. Select any of the cell, then click advanced. Then only it will recognize the previous selection. Okay, then click OK. Now see Adams. The filter the data is Adams. Now this performs a text-based search, which is exactly matched with the Adams. Yeah. Now clear the filter. I want the employee IDs. Okay, greater than 505. Then, so we're going to use the logical operators here. Like this is the greater than 505. Select anywhere in the selection, click advanced, press OK. See, greater than 505, 506, 507, we are getting the filter list, right? Clear it. So we're going to use the wildcard characters like asterisk. I want to filter starting with A. Okay, A asterisk. Enter. Advanced. Click OK. See, we are getting two rows. Yeah. Hope you understood. Clear it. Salary. Okay. Salary. I want to filter the salary lesser than 70,000. Yeah. So put lesser than 70,000. Okay, then click anywhere here, click advanced, press OK. So below 70,000 we are getting this many results. Okay, clear it. So this is how the advanced filter works. Okay, as you all see, there is another option is there. Okay, click advanced, copy to. Okay, copy to means whatever the filtered data will be copied to another location. So that is why copy to another location option is here. Select this option, click on this button, click some anywhere else here, then click OK. See, the data is automatically filled here. Okay, like I want to find Alan, I mean A starting with, click on this cell, advanced, press OK. Why? Because you have not selected the copy to location. Click on this, select this. See, clear it. We are getting this. Okay, likewise, again one more time, I want the lesser than 505 employee IDs. Okay, click on here, advanced, make sure you have selected this option and click OK. Look at this, we have selection here but not here. We have the filter data here. See, 505 and 503. So likewise, you can put this copy to somewhere else in your report and put your conditions over here, so that will filter out and copy the data to your report. Okay, this is how the second option is works. Okay, you can ask me a question. You said something like just a button of the click, right? Where is the button? Okay, let's get into it. So whenever you have to apply the filter, you need to click on this cell and click advanced, then copy this and press OK. Then only it will come, right? So there are three actions or four actions is required to filter that. So we can record those steps into a macro and assign it to a button. Let's see how it works. Okay, before that, put some button here. I'll insert some button here, shapes, okay, and I'll add text, filter, I'll do some works. Okay, so this is the button. Now I'm going to record those steps. Okay, so if you can see in your menu the developer option. Okay, if you're not able to see the developer option, no problem. Select this file, go to options, and go to the customize ribbon. Come here, so make sure you check this developer option here. Okay, then only you'll be getting this menu. Okay, now okay, we need to record the macro, right? Now select this cell, click the record macro, name your macro like filter the data, something like that, filter data, click OK, select this cell, select the data, click advanced, make sure you select this one, copy and click OK. Now stop the recording. Now we have recorded our actions. Now click on the button and you can able to see that there is a item called ascend macro. Click on that option. Click on this filter data. This one is I've used previously, so no need to worry about that. So this one we have given filter data. Click on OK. Okay, now we can try that one. I want ending with Y, something like that. Then you need to use asterisk Y. Enter. So whatever ending with Y, will be getting the filter. Click on this filter. See, that's it. It's just a click of a button. See, the asterisk is the wildcard character. As I said earlier, whatever the matches, it will not. So whatever the ending with Y, it will filter out. See here, Terry and Mercy. Terry and Mercy. Simple, right? It's very simple. Clear that. No need to clear it actually. Just delete that one. Now salary, something like that. I want the salary 6 figures, like 1 lakh, greater than is 1 lakh. Okay, or put something like that, greater than or equal to 1 lakh. Yeah. Filter it. We'll be getting the two items, Terry and Mercy again. Delete it. I want the employee IDs from 504, greater than or equal to 504. Filter it. 504, because it is greater than or equal to. See, we are getting the results copied over here. Amazing, right? So you can also use this advanced filter in your reports. And yeah, can do wonders in your reports. That's it guys. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please press like, share and comment. Also please subscribe this channel for more interesting videos. Thank you.